Good afternoon. Good afternoon.
So good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon, ma'am. Please.
So that we have a small introduction.
Please, ma'am.
Then we'll begin, sir.
Yeah, sure.
Adil, ma'am, you can start, ma'am.
Okay. Why one can't just now? Warm welcome. Yes, now the incomplete one was.
Adil, voice is breaking. Adil, my time.
A warm welcome is never incomplete without warm words. Good afternoon to all of you present here. It gives me immense joy and happiness to deliver the welcome address on this election, Art and Literature. First, I would like to thank our Lord Almighty who is gracing and blessing this day and would help us to make this program a resounding success. With great honor and respect, I extend a hearty welcome to resource person, Dr. A. Noble Jabakumar, Assistant Professor, Department of English, Periyar EVR College, Trichy. He has published 5 articles and conducted 3 conferences. He is guiding 14 scholars and attended 31 webinars from various universities. He is a specialist of Indian English Literature, ELT, Literary Criticism, Historical Literature, and Communication and Personality Skills. We feel elevated by your presence, sir. We also thank you for accepting our invitation in spite of your busy schedule. We extend a heartfelt welcome to you, sir. Welcome you, sir.
Thank you.
Next, I would like to extend my heartfelt welcome to our beloved students who participate this e-lecture on art and literature. Once again, I extend my hearty welcome to all of you for your presence. Thank you. Now, it's time to get new knowledge and ideas. I invite Dr. A. Noble Jabakumar to take the session.
Good afternoon, one and all. I'm very happy to be with you all in this afternoon section. And before going into this section, I like to do one thing. Even I like to present anywhere around the world for any presentation. I used to do something. I used to start with the words with our own mother language. It's called Mata Pita Guru Deva. I like to praise them, all these Trinity, as of being a Christian and being an Indian. Trinity is a major cause for all religion and all human beings. So I like to praise these three, Mata, Pita, Guru, Deva. Then let me get into this topic. And I would like to put up my thanks to Mrs. Angeline Priya, who has given me this opportunity to talk with you all, and my another thanks to Miss Diana, because you know that she called me and she said, "Sir, on behalf of Angeline, ma'am, she's been little busy with something, so let me take over my position to complete this process in the right way." So I'm very happy to thank you, Miss Diana and Miss Jose Rajedila, because she is doing this organizing committees and other things. Okay, so and my heartfelt thanks to all the management of Holy Cross Home Science College. And last but not the least, because I used to say the thanks to my students when I was in my college. I used to say thanks to my Romeo and Juliets. But I would like to say here, all the Juliets, thanks for your pleasureful presence at this hot, scorching time. Okay, thank you. So let us go into this topic is called art and literature. Before going into the topic of art and literature, I would like to ask you one question. Because I have mentioned your logo in the left side of my presentation, right? While you see in your logo, you can see something like a star, and one more thing is there is a three lines are there, and something like. What do you think about this particular art? Can you please explain me? Any one of you voluntarily tell me what is the meaning of this particular thing? Can you define me? What is this? This one. Is anyone? Voluntarily, please tell me what is the speciality of this particular image. What this art defines? Hello? Ma'am, you ask all the people to be quiet.
No, sir.
Yeah, please kindly tell them. Yeah.
Kindly
ask. Define what is this? This is also an art, right? Can you define what is this? Because we are doing an art and literature, like you said, the love and serve. And this is love and this has been serving and art. This is, has to be taken into a serving. That's what my question. Can you please define me what is this? What is the meaning of this particular art? Anyone? I think you have a students from third year, right, ma'am?
Yes, sir. Third year as well as PG.
Oh, very, 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 very good. That's a third year and first PG. So the third year and first PG will answer for this question. What do you think about this particular art? How it looks so? That is my question. Hello?
Sir, kindly answer. Don't be quiet. Any volunteers? Evangeline, kindly answer. Evangeline, are you there?
Yes, ma'am.
Answer. What is it? What is that image of? A college logo? Can you see a college logo?
Yes, ma'am.
Evangeline, what is happening, you know, evangelists are the people who is going to work for God. That is why your madam selecting you. Evangeline, can you please define it? Am I right, Evangeline? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Ma'am, this is my question. Generally, what is it? இவாஞ்சலிஸ்ட் அப்படின்னு சொல்லி சொன்னா என்ன சொல்லுவாங்கன்னா கடவுளுக்காக வேலை பார்ப்பவர்கள் அப்படின்னு சொல்லுவாங்க இல்லையா. As of you are the you have the name of Evangeline, that's why your madam selected you. Okay, Evangeline-னா நம்மளுக்காக கஷ்டப்பட்டு எப்படியாவது பதில் சொல்லிடுவாங்க அப்படின்னு நம்பி சொல்லியிருக்காங்க. ப்ளீஸ் நீங்க இந்த சைட்ல ரைட் சைட்ல இருக்கிற மீன் மாதிரி தப்பிச்சு போக ட்ரை பண்ணிடாதீங்க. அவங்க அங்க இருக்கிற மூணு மீன்ல உங்களை தான் பிடிச்சிருக்காங்க மேம், லாக் பண்ணிட்டாங்க. ஸோ யூ ஹாவ் டு ஆன்சர்.
கலை
அதுவே கேக்கலடா உங்களுடைய தமிழ்லயே கேக்குறோம் பிரச்சனை இல்லை பாருங்களேன் திஸ் பிக்சர் வாட் திஸ் பிக்சர் போர்ட்ரைஸ் யூ ஹாவ் அ பிக்சர் ஹியர் யூ நோ யுவர் லோகோ வென் யூ கோ த்ரூ யுவர் காலேஜ் கேலண்டர் தே கிவ் யூ திஸ் டெஃபினிஷன் வாட் இஸ் திஸ் ஆம் ஐ ரைட் What is different?
College logo right hand side la irukla da. What is that?
Is it defines an angel or is it defines something like what we said? Neenga Mary Basilica poninga nu solli sonna Velangani poninga when you see the statue it looks like this. Abey or mari idhe mari irukum. அதுவா இல்ல வேற எதுமா உங்க
காலேஜ் சார் ஐ வில் ஆன்சர் இட்ஸ் ஆர் லேடி ஹூ இஸ் எ சைன் ஆஃப் ஹோப் டு ஆர் இன்ஸ்டிடியூஷன்
ப்ளீஸ் மேம்
இட்ஸ் எ ஃபிகர் ஆஃப் ஆர் லேடி ஹூ இஸ் எ சைன் ஆஃப் ஹோப் டு ஆர் இன்ஸ்டிடியூஷன்
ஓகே ஓகே மேம் தேங்க் யூ தேங்க் யூ தேங்க் யூ தேங்க்ஸ் a lot ஓகே சோ லெட் அஸ் கோ டு தி டாபிக் தென் because I just want to ask you because while I'm seeing this particular logo I was very happy to see so this is the thing can make me to speak for 1 hour I don't need to prepare for anything by seeing this alone, which gives me an idea. I can speak a lot because what is the thing is love and share. Because our topic is art and literature. We can see a logo that this side is a cross. You said about a holy cross and it's about a Mother Mary statue or something and Holy Mary. And centrally you have an anchor. You are anchoring everything. You are giving a life to the students by. The Trinity of our God. That's what I am planning for. That is why I am asking you this question. Thank you, thank you. So then let us go into the next thing. And now we have to think about another thing. What is art and what is literature and so on. Before going to that, I just want to ask you one question. What do you think about this particular picture? It says that art is an expression of creativity and imagination. It also a relationship between the artist and the audience. So, you are seeing a person who is standing there. According to you, who is he? Is he a audience or is he an artist? Maybe she, because I am taking a class for the girls' college, so let it be. Maybe she. Is she an artist or is she an audience? Okay, leave it. Let me tell you this thing because what is the thing they want to speak about? They speaks about two different concepts. One is expression of creativity. Second one is an imagination of the artist. First one is expression of the creativity. The second one is speaks about imagination of the audience. Do you know what is the difference between an expression of the creativity and the imagination of the audience? You know, I have some kind of thought while seeing this particular picture. I can see that that particular person is being created from that particular land. Because, you know, man was created from sand. As of a biblical reference, what we came to know, God created a man from the sand. Okay, that may be, we can say that this is the first creation of the world. And this after creating this thing, the man itself started thinking in what way we are coming into the world. How do we exist into the world? That may be an imagination of the person. That's what he tries to say. What is art? Art is an expression of the creativity. The creator has an expression in his mind and he started draw on this picture. And the imagination is we can take it into our imagination and to think whatever we like on this particular art. Okay. Then he also said there is a relationship between artist and the audience. The artist is the expression of the creativity and the audience is the imagination. So is it easy to understand or you want me to go for the bilingual or something else? Is it okay?
Yes, sir, I can proceed, okay. Sir.
What is the example for this particular thing is the best example for this, you know, the movie Thola. When we see the movie Thola, we can see this particular explanation. Because Nagarjun and the hero has gone for an exhibition where he can see a picture with a red color. He simply sits and enjoying the picture for a long time. He doesn't know why he is taking this much of time there and I don't know why. Then he said, you see, what is a beautiful picture? You know the cast of this? excuse me. Then he started doing a painting, which creates the imagination of that particular hero to start the new task is called creation. So this is what we call art. The duty of the art, which creates the mind of every audience to start a new thing towards the world. Okay. And now we want to think about the next concept is called what he said about literature. Then first he thinks about an art, then he thinks about a literature. Literature is also comes under the concept is called an art. What it says, you know, you just see about the thing that shares a story and develops a theme for the audience. The art is nothing but even you splash a bit of color into the white paper, that is also art. That creates, induce your imagination to think more about this particular splash. But when you think about this literature is an art, what it shows, you know, when we think about this literature and art, you'll started going on writing about something. You have a plot. நீங்க வெங்கட் பிரபு அப்படின்னு சொல்லி ஒரு டைரக்டர் பார்த்துருப்பீங்க. வாட் இஸ் த ஸ்பெஷாலிட்டி ஆஃப் வெங்கட் பிரபு? யூ நோ, ஹி யூஸ் டு சே சம்திங் தட் ஐ டோன்ட் ஹாவ் எனி லாஜிக், ஐ நெவர் ஃபாலோ எனி லாஜிக். வைல் ஹி இஸ் கிவிங் அ மீடியா இன்டர்வியூ, ஹி செட் ஐ டோன்ட் வாண்ட் ஃபாலோ எனி கைண்ட் ஆஃப் லாஜிக், மை மூவி இஸ் டசன்ட் ஹாவ் எனி லாஜிக், என் படத்தில் எந்த லாஜிக்குமே இருக்கா, அதனால என் படத்தை வந்து லாஜிக்கோட பார்க்கணும்னு யாரும் வராதிங்க அப்படின்னு சொல்லி சொல்லுவார். என்ன பண்ணுவார்னா, ஒரு தீமை வச்சுக்குவார், அதை வச்சு ஆடியன்ஸ் என்டர்டைன் பண்றதுக்கு ஒரு விஷயத்தை புதுசாக பண்ணுறது. திஸ் இஸ் வாட் வி கால் அ லிட்ரேச்சர். வைல் வி சி சம் பிக்சர்ஸ் ஹியர், யூ நோ தட் திஸ் பிக்சர் வாட் டிஃபைன்ஸ், திஸ் இஸ் அபவுட் த கிஷ் டேப்லெட்ஸ் விச் இஸ் பீன் டன் இன் த டைம் ஆஃப் சுமேரியன் சிவிலைசேஷன். அட் த டைம் ஆஃப் சுமேரியன் சிவிலைசேஷன் விச் இஸ் பீன் கெப்ட் அப் இன் ஆக்ஸ்போர்ட் ஆஸ்மோலன் லைப்ரரி, திஸ் இஸ் த ஃபர்ஸ்ட் ரைட்டிங்ஸ், திஸ் இஸ் த ஃபர்ஸ்ட் டைப் ஆஃப் ரைட்டிங் விச் இஸ் பீன், யூ நோ. When you see this particular tablets, you will see a lot of pictures here, you know. These arts are all considered to be a writings. So, where the writing starts? The writing starts from the art. Writing அப்படிங்கிறது எங்க ஸ்டார்ட் பண்ணுதுன்னா ஆர்ட்ல தான் ஸ்டார்ட் பண்ணுது. According to me, I like to say something about this literature. What is my definition on literature? You know that lit means light. So, you know the meaning of lit. Lit means light. An era means a long period. When we divide it into LIT, lit, ERA, era, era means a long period. And about the ter, T-U-R-E, ter, ter is a word which is taken from Latin and Greek. That will be called as Thor's warrior, Thor's warrior. You know about Thor. Thor's warrior is about an imagination. What it means, you know that it's imagination. Who is Thor? Thor is a god of thunder, you know. Lighting the mind of someone to stand for a long period of this world, to stand for a long period of this world with a thundering type of writings is called literature. Now we understand what is art and what is literature. Art is the expression and imagination. Literature is also an art which defines and develop a theme for the audience, which will lead the world to a right way, and moreover, which will do something what we called make a people to write about something for a long standing things. This is about the differentiation of art and literature, how we implement literature into the art. Okay, have you seen this picture now? Hello, have you seen the picture? Yeah, okay. What it defines, literature and other fine arts are similar in their specific media. What is it says, you know, similar in specific media and through one gives an expression. I like to ask you one question. While seeing this picture, what is your opinion about this look? What is your opinion about this, about the look of this particular girl? What do you think about the look of this girl? Sir, in English, la solla varadhu korvai appadina onnum prachana illa, Tamil la kuda solalam. I like to accept it. Can you please tell me? What do you think about this particular look? What do you think about the expression of this girl? இந்த பெண்ணுடைய எக்ஸ்பிரஷன் என்னன்னு நீங்க நினைக்கிறீங்க? ஹலோ,
she express her feeling.
Okay, very good.
Her feeling that she show in her face.
Very good. What type of feeling? Have you seen the movie Maina?
No, sir.
No. Oh, you didn't see the movie Maina. Movie paakala, isn't it? Okay, right. Is there anyone have seen the movie Maina?
Others, kindly answer.
நான் மட்டும் தனியாவே பேசிட்டு இருப்பேன், அது ரொம்ப நேரத்தில் உங்களுக்கு போர் அடிச்சு போயிடும். என்னடா அவர் பேசிட்டே இருக்காரு, ஒண்ணுமே புரியல அப்படின்ற மாதிரி வெறுத்து போயிடும். அதுக்காக தான் ஐ ஜஸ்ட் மேக் திஸ் கைண்ட் ஆஃப் இன்டராக்டிவ் ஆஸ்பெக்ட்ஸ்.
எனி அதர்ஸ் ஹூ ஹேவ் சீன் திஸ் மூவி கைண்ட்லி ஆன்சர்.
Okay, right. One of the girl has given me an answer, right? You said about that an expression of a girl. She shows her feeling. In the feeling, and the kannunudaiya feeling vandu ungalku paakum bodhu, what do you see? Is it a sorrowness? Is it what we call an envy? Or is it called something like, correct-a Tamil-la solanum appadina, na onbadhu pulangal-nu solvaanga. Sogama kattraangala, illa or garuvatha kattraangala, illa or garuvamum sogamum kalandha mugama kattraangala. என்னவா இருக்கு அந்த கண்ணு? ஹலோ,
she lost something, I think, sir.
Very good, she lost something. I like you. What is your name?
Evangeline.
ஓ, இவாஞ்சலின தனியா பிடிச்சி வச்சனால இவாஞ்சலின் பரவாயில்ல, பதில் சொல்லிக்கிட்டே இருக்காங்க. வெரி குட், தட்ஸ் வை ஐ கால் யூ ஆர் இவாஞ்சலிஸ்ட். ஓகே ஓகே, இவாஞ்சலின், தேங்க்யூ ஃபார் யுவர் ஆன்சர் இவாஞ்சலின். I like Thank your you. answer, because you know, while I'm seeing this movie, I really admire the face of this particular character. When I spoke with Prabhu Salaman, who was my senior in St. Joseph's College, you know, I asked him, where did you select this particular character? He said, I'm searching for many people, but I didn't get through that. Finally, I've seen this particular girl suited for this particular character, because in the ponnu vandu oru majestic ah nadipa, வீட்டுக்காரனை விட்டு கொடுக்க மாட்டா, எப்போ பார்த்தாலும் நீ வரியா வரமாட்டியா அப்படின்னு கேட்பா. பிகாஸ் ஷீ பிலாங்ஸ் டு அ ராயல் ஃபேமிலி, அண்ட் ஐ மீன் ஷீ இஸ் அ ஒன்லி கேர்ள் இன் த ஃபேமிலி வித் ஃபோர் ஆர் த்ரீ பிரதர்ஸ். ஸோ ஷீ ஹேஸ் அன் அட்மினிஸ்ட்ரேட்டிவ் தாட், லைக் டம்பிங் அதர்ஸ் ஆட்டிடியூட். அட் த டைம் ஆஃப் கிளைமேக்ஸ், த ஹீரோ தட் ஹர் ஹஸ்பண்ட் கில்ட் ஹர், அட் த டைம் ஷீ மேக்ஸ் அ லுக். நான் ஒரு லுக்கு தான் இங்கே போட்டிருக்கேன், இந்த லுக்கு வந்து நாலு விதமாக இருக்கும். I love that outlook, that look or a face or a look, na romba virumbren. This is called an art. What art we see in literature, we will see the expression, we will see the beauty of the expression through this particular literature. Literature alone can give us the beauty of emotions, the beauty of everything, right? So now we are going into the concept is called, what are all the subdivision, traditional subdivision of art? Now, we have an explanation like architecture, sculpture, painting, literature, music, performing and film. So, rather giving all this thing, I would have to tell you what are all this thing, right? What is architecture? We have an example of architecture in Tanjai Pragadeeswarar Koil and Madurai temple. And these are all the examples of Tamil Nadu architectural beauty. And you know about the sculpture. Sculpture, we can see a lot of sculptures around these particular temples itself, and about the paintings of mural paintings, and we have lot of paintings around the world which gives a beauty of everything. Mural painting is specialized in Indian art, and we used to speak about the painting like Michelangelo and everyone, right? So this is what we call traditional subdivisions of art. Then the fourth one, you know, what is the fourth one? Fourth one plays a major role in our life. This is called a literature. Literature is the one which is coming under the divisions of arts. And then about music, and music you are all familiar, and what is a performing arts, what is performing arts, another thing we will know. And the final thing is a film. And what are all the genre of art? We simply thinking about the art now, we are not going to think about literature or something like art. An artist, when an artist can do, what type of art can be done? That about a contemporary art, and about pop art and abstract expressionism, cubism, art deco, art nouveau, post-impressionism and impressionism, pre-Raphaelite brotherhood and surrealism. These are all the genre of art. An artist will follow these kind of genres while they want to do some art. So these are all the types of art, genre of art in art, in general art. Okay. Then what are all the key elements of art? These are all the main things of an art. When you want to become an artist, you want to start doing an art, what are all the key lines you have to follow? It's about a line, color, value, and shape, form, space, and texture. Without all these things, we can't do a beautiful art. Even in a line, we can specify more things. When a straight line will define on some part of a character in a person, and a crossed line will define about something. I will tell you this example. I think you are all familiar about a proposition. You know, a proposition. What is a proposition? Proposition of direction. I am crossing the road. I like to across the road. I like to cross the road. There is a differentiation between cross the road and across the road. I think you understand what is the meaning between this. Cross the road is going straight and across the road will move like this. I like to go through the roads, and that means that we are moving straightly towards the right. This is what we call an example of a line. And these are all the basic explanation I will give you. And about the genre of literature. Now we are coming into our own subject. What is a genre of literature? Genre of literature has different types. It's about 7 types of genre of literature. First is called a prose. Everything will come under the prose. No need to define in a different way, but I want to explain you in the right way. That's why I'm telling you. The first part of a thing is called a prose. Prose has different concept. What is prose? Prose is nothing but ordinary and day-to-day life, which is written in the format of ordinary and day-to-day life. The language which is used in a prose is a normal language, and moreover, what is used in a day-to-day life language will be used in particular prose. When you want to write down a prose, we don't need to go for a what we call a rhythmic words and meter and about the poetic aspects. We can write as it is in a normal way. If you want to put up some mark of phrasal aspect, we'll use some phrase words or something. This is called a prose. Where the word prose is being defined? The prose is being defined by the word is called prosa of Latin. It means a straightforward. Why we call it as prose? Because it means a straightforward. Prosa is a word taken from Latin. It means a straightforward. The straightforward means even in every straightforward aspect, we don't want to explain in a rhythm or something like that. That is why we want to go into a thing is called prose. Prose has two different concepts, fiction and non-fiction. Okay. Why we write to prose? Why do you want to write a prose? We want to convince and we want to inform something to the reader. We want to convince the mind of an audience. We like prose. Pamphlets, prose, these are all the best example for a prose. The next thing is called a poetry. What is the special of the poetry? How we write poetry? Poetry is a metrical and rhythmical, also a figurative language. When you want to write down a poetry, we should have to follow these kind of regulations when you want to write a poetry. Without this, no one can enjoy the poetry. If I ask you to do something like, can you please tell me 2 lines about mother or father or something? Are you ready to give me a poetic words on? நம்ம கிளாஸ்ல ஒரு க்வெஸ்சன் கேட்குறேன்னு வச்சுக்கோங்களேன். சிம்பிள் க்வெஸ்சன், நம்ம அம்மாவை பற்றி ஒரு கவிதை சொல்லுங்க அப்படின்னு சொல்லி சொன்னால் இவாஞ்சலினை விட்டுருவோம். பாவம் இவாஞ்சலி, ரொம்ப நேரமாக மாட்டிகிட்டே இருக்காங்க. அதனால் இவாஞ்சலினை விட்டுட்டு வில் கோ ஃபார் சம்மோன் எல்ஸ் டு கிவ் பொய்டிக் வேர்ட்ஸ் அபவுட் மதர். யாராவது ஒருத்தர் கிளாஸில் இந்த நம்ம அட்டன் பண்ணிட்டு இருக்கவங்களை யாராவது ஒருத்தர் ப்ளீஸ் கேன்லி டெல் மீ அ ஃபியூ பொய்டிக் லைன்ஸ் அபவுட் மதர்.
Sir, I call upon Arnisha to answer this.
She's a great word.
No, sir, she's good at words making.
Okay, please, ma'am. Sorry. Sure.
Arnisha, are you there? Arnisha?
I think she is right. She is the right person to call, but left the meeting. I think so.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Oh, she said yes. Sorry. Please, ma'am.
Anisha. Versify three lines
yes, ma'am.
About motherhood or something.
About motherhood, ma'am.
Yes.
Or a mother.
Poetic, poetic. Kavitha eluduvaangala adhu mari.
Poetically,
உங்கள மொபைல் வச்சிருக்கீங்கல்ல
Sir, okay. Voice break out, sir.
You have a mobile with your hands, right? You have your mobile, na?
Yes, sir, I have my mobile.
You love your mobile, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, you say three lines about your mobile.
About my mobile, it's always with me like 24/7, and I can, it's become like a small world. In your palms, the world is there because you can find anything. It's like a speech and thing. It's not poetical at all.
I like you to put up something like, I can pick up words from your things, right? It's a small world, but I can take down anything from this particular mobile, right? You said these words, right? That's a small one, which will give you everything about the world, right?
Yeah, it's kind of like in your palms, the world is present. Something like that.
Yeah, great. Can you make it into a poetical sense of this? That is called an art.
Poetical.
Yes. Poetical sense. Let me know. If you are familiar in Tamil, you can say in Tamil. It's not an issue.
I'm comfortable with English, sir, but at the moment, I think I can't think of it properly.
Okay.
You can guide me through it, sir. Just give me an example. I will lead you.
You want me to suggest you some examples, right? Yeah.
Yes.
You can. What's the model of your mobile?
Vivo Y17.
Vivo.
Y7.
Y7. Right. So your mobile is Y7.
Yes, sir.
Y7. Why I like seven?
Yeah.
Okay, why I like 7?
Okay.
Because it's why 7? Simply over, no? Why I like 7? Because it's why 7?
It's really nice, sir. It's really nice.
Right. Thank you. Abhi, I am asking you a question. You make me become a participant over there. Thank you. I like to be a student of you. Okay. Because you convert me as a student now. I love to be a student, right? I love to be a student, yeah. Right? Shall I have some words from you? Because I have given my explanation. What about you?
From me?
Yeah.
Sir, as I'm mesmerized by your thing, I'm kindly out of ideas, but I really love to say something. Sir, I really love poetry.
Okay.
But I'm running out of ideas right now, sir.
Of course, you have to, because you, even though you have Vivo with your hands, you have to drink Viva for, what is that, a poetic lines. Am I right? Have you ever heard Viva? V-I-Viva. V-I-V-A. It has 7 proteins. Everything different type of things is inside. So you love to have that Viva, to have your Vivo Y7, because you are the one, you know, as you said, Y7, do you know what is the speciality of a Y? What is the spelling of a girl?
Y speciality.
No, what is the meaning of a, what is the spelling of a girl?
G-I-R-L.
Great. What is the spelling of a boy?
B-O-Y.
And you please, what's your mobile now? Vivo?
Why?
Why? And please pronounce a word called B O Y.
B O Y.
What is B
O Y? You're making. Wait, you're making rhymes, right, sir? Like rhymatic
scheme. What is B O Y? Please pronounce B O Y. What is B O Y?
B O Y is kind of like B O Y.
Yeah, what is B O Y? G I R L is a girl.
B O Y is boy.
B O Y? Is that? Hello? It's a boy.
It's a boy. Oh, yes, I get it.
Very bad. G-Y is a guy. And you have a Y. Thank you. This is what we call a poetry, right? Shall we go to the next one?
Okay, sir.
Yeah, thank you. And what are all the seven elements of narrative? Narrativeness is these seven elements. First is called a plot. And about a setting, and about the characters, and about the point of view, and about the theme, and about the symbolism, and about the conflict. Have you seen this picture here? Does this picture is visible to you all? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, okay, right. Then, what are all the elements of writing is about a plot, setting, characters, point of view, theme, symbolism, and conflict. You know, we have a poetry called Artist, Lover, and the Bird Watcher. Have you ever read this poetry? Artist, Poet, and the Bird Watcher. Sorry, Artist, Lover, and the Bird Watcher. We have a poetry like this. Why they have given a title Artist, the Poet, the Lover, and the Bird Watcher. Sorry, the Poet, the Lover, and the Bird Watcher. Why do they select this particular title? Why? Do you know why? Because these three guys always think about single aspect. When you think about the lover always think about partner. When you think about the poet always think about the central theme of poetry. When you think about the bird watcher, what is the duty of a bird watcher? He simply or she simply sits in a place, tries to listen what is the speciality of the bird. This is called the seven elements of narrative. Okay, I am very sorry. I think I have taken a lot of time of yours. If is it a problem for you all? Hello? If it goes a bit of 10 minutes extra, is it not a problem or is it a problem?
No, sir, you can extend.
Okay, thank you. Then these are all the elements of narrative aspects of writings in literature. And about what is now we are coming into the topic. This particular arts will be taken into triangular dimension. What is the triangle? First, it speaks about literary arts. The second one is called the performing arts. And the third one is called the visual arts. What is the specialty of literary arts and the performing arts and visual arts? Let us think about this particular thing. Now we go into the thing. What is a literary art? The literary art will speaks about drama, poetry, and prose. Now, as of we have discussed the same thing before, so on the regard, Miss Abisha has given a poetic words or something that she has a why of why questions and why, and it's very hard to create a word from why. That's why she has some trouble in giving a poetry. Okay, so let us think about. This is the thing what we call the drama, poetry, and prose are all the things used to be called as literary arts. And what is a performing arts? You know, as a literature students, we must give much importance to the performing arts. The theater performances, music, dance, and film. And I like to put up some question on this particular concept, you know, that the specialty of a performing arts, I like to tell you something because when I joined into the, before joining to the government college, I worked for an engineering college where I pick up my students for a cultural event in one of the reputed institution in Tirchiappalli, and where we like to perform the scene of court scene of what he said, a Merchant of Venice, the port scene of Merchant of Venice. In this particular group, we have two girls and about a boy and four boys and two girls are asked to perform an arts inside, perform a drama over there in this particular institution. You know that. There's two girls. One girl is doing a character of Portia, and another girl is doing a character of Nerissa, and another boy who is performing a character of Shylock, and the hero whose name is Bassanio, right? Antonio. The character of Antonio and Bassanio. And there are two guardians who have to stand there. We have to convert the story into a different comical way or something. You know, what was happened? I prefer a student who is able to speak English in the right way. He has been acted as Shaila. And I selected these two girls. One is a Nerissa and another one is a Portia. Because I know about the capacity of these two girls and about this boy. And moreover, others don't need to speak more. And we have given changing the dialects in a normal way and so on. While you know that they have started doing a drama. While doing a drama, you know what is happening over there. Shylock started speaking about his dialogue. When the Shylock's dialogue is over, the guard who has to stand who's standing behind Shylock has to call, Nerissa, please come. And Portia, you please come. And this is the word he has to say. Then he said, please come. Then she is coming and started speaking out. And after that, you know, again, Nerissa has to speak a few dialogues. After this particular dialogue, our Antonio has to speak. I have make a person to act like an Antonio. He is standing in the side of Shaila. You know, he said, hey, ippa yen dialogue kadaila. Ayyo, enna pesa udada. Please, 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 please. Nee vera evanadhu pesiko. Abdin solli solta. This is what we call... We like to do some comical aspects over there, but you know, he doesn't know how to speak. He doesn't know what is a dialogue. So he missed his dialogue. He said, no, naa pesamaten. This is not my turn to speak. You ask someone to speak. I'm not here. And this is the specialty of a performing arts in literature. What is the special? You know, you're all familiar about Shakespeare. Why Shakespeare becomes very famous in literature? Yeah, Shakespeare literature la famous anara. Yaravu solla mudiyuma? Is there any answer for this? From your side, I like to, now I am a student here and you are all my lecturers or professors or readers, whatever you love, you can take it into the sense. And can you please tell me why Shakespeare becomes famous, then how he becomes famous? What makes him famous? Any answers? Hello? Shakespeare ஏன் ஃபேமஸ் ஆனார் ஷேக்ஸ்பியரோட ஸ்பெஷாலிட்டி என்ன அண்ட் ஹவு ஹி பிகம்ஸ் ஃபேமஸ் வாட் இஸ் த ஸ்பெஷாலிட்டி ஆஃப் ஹிஸ் ஃபேம் ஷேக்ஸ்பியரோட ஸ்பெஷாலிட்டி என்ன எனி ஐடியா வாட் இஸ் த ப்ரொஃபஷன் ஆஃப் ஷேக்ஸ்பியர் பிஃபோர் ஹி டர்ன்ஸ் இன்டு அ பிளே ரைட் பிளேஸ் Vasumari, thank you. Please. So Vasumari said it's place.
I hope PG students can answer.
Popular in sonnets. Wow, Evangeline. That's why they want you to answer for everything. Popular in sonnets. Good. Any other? What is the profession of Shakespeare before he turns himself as a playwright? Due to his own imagination. Very good. Anything else? ஷேக்ஸ்பியர் வந்து ஒரு பிளே ரைட் ஆகிறதுக்கு முன்னாடி என்னவா இருந்தார் அப்படிங்கிறது ஏதாவது ஐடியா இருக்கா இருக்கும் don't know, right? He is the one who is guarding the hearts. In the theater, he is taking care of the hearts. While sitting in that area, which is very close to that first class segment. So, he likes to listen everything. Ella vishayangaliyum listen pannaar. Ukkaandhu minute listen panni. Then there is an imagination, as you said, of an intuition of a mind, which makes him to become a writer. Then he started writing a lot of things. Avar vandhu unmaiya sollunna nama Atli mari. Nammaloada director Atli mari. Pakkava sollunna example vandhu sollunna Atli dhaan. Because all this place which is being extracted from Northwest Tales of Latin. Ella tales me eduthu paathina Northwest lende edukapattavigal dhaan. Julian Caesar and about, Antony and Cleopatra and Othello and everything, which are all taken from Northwest Tales. This is the real fact. Well, you taken into a history of Shakespeare, you'll learn this one. Why he becomes famous? Because he performs arts. He performs arts in the stages. He has created play to make the people to be entertained, to make the people to be outburst the feelings inside what is inside the mind. This is what the performing arts in literature. Literature or your main concept, performing arts, which will take out the emotions, outburst of the emotions from the bottom to the top. Top mind, the soul, this is what we call the speciality of the performing arts. This is called a drama. This is called a theatrical activity. The specialist in this particular performing arts is Shakespeare. He's the best example for this. And you know, one more thing, what is the special? I like to ask you one question. Have you ever read Twelfth Night or what we said, Tempest? Twelfth Night or Tempest? Now, a word, a stanza. If music be the food of love, give me excess of it. This is the quotation.
Sir, shall I answer?
With pleasure, please.
Opening lines of Twelfth Night.
Very good. What is the speciality of if music be the food of love, give me excess of it? What is the mind of that particular Ferdinand? Feeling எப்படி இருந்தது எதனால அப்படி சொன்னான் ஹி இஸ் இன் தி மூட் ஆஃப் ஹலோ
மேபி எலைட்டட் ஃபீலிங்
மேபி
எலைட்டட் ஃபீலிங்
எலைட்டட் ஃபீலிங் வெரி குட் வெரி குட் திஸ் இஸ் கால்ட் எ பெர்ஃபார்மிங் ஆர்ட்ஸ் திஸ் இஸ் வாட் வி கால்ட் எ ஸ்பெஷாலிட்டி ஆஃப் லிட்டரேச்சர் இன் பெர்ஃபார்மிங் ஆர்ட்ஸ் சோ லெட் அஸ் ஸ்டெப் இன்டு தி நெக்ஸ்ட் திங் இஸ் கால்ட் தி விஷுவல் ஆர்ட்ஸ் வாட் இஸ் தி விஷுவல் ஆர்ட்ஸ் தி விஷுவல் ஆர்ட்ஸ் இஸ் நதிங் பட் a graphical arts and a design. Term and utilitarian arts are a commercial art. Have you seen the picture here? There are two faces there. One is a tiger and another one is a lady, right? And have you seen the pause here? The pakringla in the picture oda speciality enna nu yaravu solla mudiyuma? Is there anyone is ready to explain what is the speciality of this picture? Any answers? Because I think I am speaking to a girls' college, right? Isn't so?
Yes,
right?
Sir.
Oh, okay. Thank you. இல்ல நாமளாவே எல்லா காலேஜ்லயுமே பாய்ஸ் காலேஜ்லயுமே ஐ மீன் கோயட் காலேஜ்ல பத்தினா கேள்வி கேட்டோம்னா டங்னு ஒரு பொண்ணு தான் எழுந்துச்சு டக்கு டக்கு டக்குனு பதில் சொல்லும். நம்ம இதுல கேர்ள்ஸ்க்கே நான் பதில் கேட்கறேன்னா பதிலே சொல்ல மாட்டேங்குது பயப்படுறீங்க. ஐ டோன்ட் நோ வை. அண்ட் மோர் ஓவர் what is the speciality of a girls college, you know, and of a literary students? Sir, we are all feminist, you know. We feminist, we always answer in the right way. You don't have to dump us. I'm silly solvanga. But though you are a feminist, you are not able to answer this question. Why?
Sir, your screen is not visible, it seems, for the students.
Not visible, eh?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
பிரசன்டேஷன் எதுவுமே சுத்தமா இல்லையா இல்ல இது மட்டும் வரலையா
சார் எதுவுமே இல்ல உங்க ஸ்கிரீன் மட்டும் தெரியுது
இப்போ தெரியதா இஸ் இட் கிளியர் ஆர் நாட்
நோ சார்
நோ நோட் அட் ஆல் 1 செகண்ட் Is it okay now?
Yes, sir.
Okay, yes, sir.
Okay. Well, can you please give me an answer of this particular picture? The second image. The first image. Have you seen the tiger and about women inside of the tigers? In the clutches of the tiger, am I right? As of a feminist thought, what will be your answer? Gomadi, now okay, start me, badal kurtingi. Idhuk badal solun. Any answers, please?
A lady is screaming because of the wind.
Anything?
A lady is screaming because of the wind.
After the, you are speaking about the second one. I am asking you the first one. That's a good answer. A lady is screamed because of the wind. Good. Great. And about the first one? Yes, ma'am. எல்லாம் முடிச்சிட்டீங்கன்னா முடிச்சிட்டே நீங்களே பதில் சொல்லுங்கன்னு சொன்னா நான் சொல்லிடுவேன். என் மைண்ட்ல என்ன தோணுச்சு அப்படின்னு சொல்லுங்க. எக்ஸ்கியூஸ் மீ. நோ ஆன்சர்ஸ். ஷலை ஷலை கிவ்
ஓகே சார்.
ஓகே ரைட். வாட் ஐ திங்க் அபவுட் திஸ் பர்டிகுலர் திங்? All women are keeping into the clutches of the men, as it is in feminist thought. When you think about the feminist thought in the first picture defines, as of what we said, there are social evils which is being engulfed the women of India. As current scenario, a lot of things is happening in North India and different places, you know, that this is what the explanation of it. We are being engulfed. Face of a lady is here. She has been engulfed. Even she is a very strong girl, or even she is a very strong woman, she has been engulfed by some kind of evil. That is what the meaning of it. I think so. That is what I think so. I'm not forcing you. You must think on it. And about the second part, even though we can see two more people are walking behind her, she is afraid of it. Maybe these two people will do something negative on them, and this surrounded aspects will put her down, which makes her to be in sets of her mind. This is what I think about this particular art. And okay, shall we go to the next one? Is it right or my definition is wrong? This is called the second part of called a visual arts. First is called a performing arts, and the second one is called a visual arts. Shall you go to the next one? Okay. Is it visible now?
Yes, sir.
Okay. This speaks about the literature is the intimation of an action by language. This is what we call a tragedy. Literature is an intimation of an action by language. Language, for example, you're all familiar about that interjection. What do you mean by interjection? I like to ask you one thing. How many of you are the fans of CSK? CSK fan, ethana per idhula irukinge? Girls, have you watched the cricket match? No?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Idhula ethana per CSK oda fan irukinge? Ethana per CSK fan illama MI or some other fan? Adala utruvom. Just leave off. Here is my mobile. Okay. If I drop the mobile here, it will fall down and broken. இப்ப என்னோட இமோஷன் எப்படி இருக்கும், உங்க இமோஷன் எப்படி இருக்கும்? This is called intimation of an action by language. இந்த மொபைல் வந்து என் கையில இருந்து கீழே வந்து உடைஞ்சிருது, சரியா? இதுல இந்த கிளாஸ்ல உட்காந்துருக்கிறதுல ஒரு ரெண்டு பேர் வந்து என்னைய பிடிக்காது, மித்தவங்களுக்கு பிடிக்குது. ஓகேயா? பிடிச்சவங்களோட இமோஷன் எப்படி இருக்கும், பிடிக்காதவங்களோட இமோஷன் எப்படி இருக்கும்? வித் த டயலாக் ஓஹெச் சரியா முன்னாடி வேர்டு ஓஹெச் ஓ ஓகே இட் ட்ராப்ட் அவ்வளோதான் அடுத்த சென்டென்ஸ் ஓ ஓ இட் ட்ராப்ட் இதுதான் அந்த வேர்டு இந்த சென்டென்ஸ் இதே என்னை பிடிச்சவங்க எப்படி சொல்லுவீங்க என்னை பிடிக்காதவங்க எப்படி சொல்லுவீங்க பிடிக்கலன்னு நிறைய பேர் வச்சுக்கோங்களேன் அவங்க யாராவது ஒரு எக்ஸாம்பிள் சொல்லுங்க answers please hello
girls don't be dumb kindly answer
okay adha no one interested in cricket appa adha uttu veliya vantom namme இப்போ என் கையில் இருக்க என் மொபைல் ஃபோன் கீழே விழுந்துருச்சு இப்போ இந்த கிளாஸில் வந்து நிறைய பேருக்கு போர் அடித்து உட்காந்துருப்பீங்க ஒரு சிலருக்கு இன்ட்ரெஸ்டோடு உட்காந்துருப்பீங்க இப்போ இன்ட்ரெஸ்டாக உட்காந்துருக்கவங்க அந்த லெட் சென்டென்ஸே கொடுத்துருவேன் ஓஹெச் ஓ இட் ட்ராப்ட் இட்ஸ் இட் ட்ராப்ட் அவ்வளோதான் இதுதான் அந்த சென்டென்ஸ் இந்த இந்த சென்டென்ஸை போர் அடிக்காமல் ஜாலியாக இருக்கவங்க எப்படி சொல்லுவீங்க இல்லை போர் அடிச்சு இப்போ என்னடா அவர் இன்னும் போட்டு ராடியாக போட்டே இருக்காரு எப்போ தான் நிறுத்துவாரோ அப்படின்னு நினைக்கிறவங்க எப்படி சொல்லுவீங்க அப்படி இல்லைன்னா மீடியமா பரவாயில்ல நடத்துட்டும் அப்படின்னு நினைக்கிறவங்க எப்படி இந்த சென்டென்ஸ் சொல்லுவீங்க நீங்க இப்ப சென்டென்ஸ் சொன்னு நீங்க அப்படி நினைக்கிறீங்கன்னு நான் நினைச்சுக்க மாட்டேன் அதனால கவலைப்பட வேணாம் தைரியமா சொல்லுங்க ஐ லைக் டு நோ அபவுட் திஸ் பர்டிகுலர் ஆக்ஷன் பை லாங்குவேஜ் தட் இஸ் வை ஐ அம் கிவிங் யூ திஸ் சென்டென்ஸ்
சார் ஐ சே சம்திங் சார்
யா ப்ளீஸ்
I got a smile it's broken smile பண்ணுவ சார்
smile or ow it's broken and our happiness oh very good huh? This is what we call an action by language you know oh it's broken அதான் you know and the emotion you know that emotion of what is coming out of oh it's broken then you think about a normal aspect you know another one oh it's broken This is the second aspect. Another one is, oh, it's broken. You know, how we spell out a word, how we speak a word, the language itself speaks about the emotion of a person. This is called literature. The intimation, the imitation of an action by a language. Every action has a beautiful language of exposure. That is what I'm interested in telling you. Thank you for the answer. May I know your name, please?
Ramya sir
okay Ramya thank you Ramya then the next thing is about asset is about the art this is speaks about Hamlet act 4 scene 7 have you seen this picture is it clear
yes sir
okay is there anyone is interested in reading out this particular lines because I don't have a poetic way of exposure kindly someone please because your voice are very sweet please is there anyone is interested in reading out this particular thing rather of myself no one this art is being done by Sir John Evert Millais in the year of 1851 to 1852 This character is about Ophelia. Excuse me. When you go through the Hamlet, we have a character called Ophelia. How she feels? What is the emotion when her father was gone out? You know, fell in the weeping brook, her cloth spread wide and murmured like a while they bore her up. Which time she chanted snatches of old tunes and we have some words are there. You know, have you seen the brook here the picture shows the brook here okay you can see the brooks here also her cloths spread wide we can see the spreading of the cloths we can see the spreading of the cloths have you seen the picture is it clear to you
sir
yes is it clear
it's clear sir
okay Have you seen the picture? This picture shows you the brook. Also, the cloth is being spread wide. Her cloth is spread wide. And it's also chanted as old tunes. Have you seen how she is lying down? Like she is lying like something different, listening something or feeling something guilty on that. And till that her garment heavy with her drink, pull the poor wretch from her melodious lay to marry death. Sorry, to marry death. Have you seen the special of this particular word, melodious lay? Garments, melodious lay, but the last word, have you seen that? Muddy death. We can see the beauty of everything, but what is the outcome of the beauty? That is about death. When we enjoy everything, whatever in the world, what is the final thing we are going to do? We will be taken into a muddy area. We will be taken into a place. That is the beautiful of here. We can see through the pictures. You know, both sides are covered with the earth. And here you can see the beauty of brook. This is what the speciality of an art in literature. Okay. And next thing about the poetry. Because we have already discussed about poetry. Poetry is nothing but is about the music. Have you seen the picture here? What is the speciality of the picture? Can you see this? Because we have seen a musical note and also a boy is dancing, or about, as you think about a girl, it looks like a boy, because that's why I'm telling you. A boy is dancing here. This may be called as a ballad dance. Or is there any fine arts students inside of this classroom? Hello? Any dancers are here? அம்மா கிளாஸ் ரூம்ல யாரும் டான்சர் இருக்கீங்களா இந்த கிளாஸ்ல? ஹலோ, இந்த கிளாஸ்ல யாரும் டான்சர் இருக்கீங்களா? எஸ் சார். ஓகே, லிங்க முத்து முத்து சுவாதி. ஏன் சாரி சுவாதி, நீங்க என்ன
டான்ஸ்?
You have mentioned that some few of the students are there, right?
Sir, I don't dance.
But you know dance. What is dancing, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Please tell me what are all the special aspects of dancing. உங்களுக்கு தெரிஞ்ச வரைக்கும் சொல்லுங்க.
It's give plus some pleasure, sir.
It gives some pleasure. Okay. You know one thing I would like to tell you about the dance. Dance has different type of aspects. We used to say, when we ask someone, do you dance? Yes, sir, I dance. What type of dance you will do? Sir, as of, you know, that class, school, I dance, sir. College, I dancing, sir. What type of dancing you are doing? They will not be able to give you an answer. In that, we have special things about our own literature, about the jazz. We have a dance called a jazz, and we have a dance called a ballet, and we have a dance called another one more, which has been very famous for this actress. Oh, very nalla varum dance, marandu pochu. I can speak about two different dance. One is about the jazz dance, and another one is for jazz is salsa ballet. What is the speciality of these three dances? These three dances, which is being used regularly in literature. Well, we see literary aspects, different types of plays. Each and every play will use to speaks about the dance of these three aspects. One is about jazz dance. Jazz dance is famous for Harlem Renaissance. Harlem people, this is about a black people used to go on. The style is called jazz. This music is called jazz. This is called a jazz dance. Another one is called a salsa. Salsa is also one type of rock, interesting, and about a saxophone make of dance. And another one is called ballet. These are all the three types of dance which has been clearly taken into this part. It's called poetry. Poetry is often said to the music, or dance interprets music. Art imitates literary form, which is called, what are all the arts is imitates here in this literary form is music, dance. Music and dance, which have been clubbed into one particular part, is called the poetry. That is what I said. Miss Abhi, right? Miss Abhi has Y in her hand. That is why she is not yelling to say why I have Y71. அப்படின்னு அவங்களுக்கு சொல்ல தெரியல. மிஸ் அபி ஹாஸ் ஒய் இன் ஹர் ஹேண்ட், ஷி ஹாஸ் அ ஒய் தாட், தட்ஸ் வை ஷி இஸ் நாட் இன்ட்ரெஸ்டட் டு சே Y7 இன் ஹர் ஹேண்ட் அப்படின்னு சொல்லி அவங்களால சொல்ல தெரியல அப்படின்னு சொல்லி அதுக்கு தான் சொன்னேன். ஒய் 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 we can use the word, it's called why. I'm sorry, சொல்லலாம். Then, you know, this why gives us a pleasure of music and also a dancing state. Why she has this, why. No, this is what we call a poetical term, which has been in an arts. Next is about, this is the example for Lady of Shalott, which has been drawn by John William Waterhouse, it has been posted in 2016 in Tate, a museum of Tate, where it has been kept up by Lady Shalott in 1888, oil painted medicine, made in 1888. I think you are all familiar about Alfred Lord Tennyson's Lady Shalott. Are you sure?
No, sir, they have.
Lady Shalott, what is the specialty of a Lady Shalott? Okay, let it be, leave it. And at the closing of the day, she loosed the chain, and down she lay, the brood stream bore her far away, the Lady Shalott. Have you seen the streams? We can see the streams here. She loosed her chain, and she lay on the board, broad stream bore. Stream la periya nalla stream la eri ukanda veliya vara idhula enna vishayam appo na you have to keep in mind broad stream, the speciality of a broad stream coming out from a narrow mind to a broad area. She is being kept in a narrow place. She can enjoy her beauty by seeing in a mirror, but she is not enjoying the beauty of outset. She is not able to enjoy the beauty of her nature. She is being narrowed in a place. Now she is standing out in a broad stream, bore her far away. This is what we call a music, and this is what we call a imagination is being kept into the music, making a people to enjoy the beauty of music. This is called the poetry. Then, I think you are familiar about this Troy. This is the example of best example for performing arts. You know, in Troy, Troilus and Cressidus, we have this particular concept. While he kills Menoclus, he used to speak some dialects. But what is the performing of arts in literature? Why we call it as a performing of arts in literature? Literary art attempts to solidify, communicate and embellish thoughts and communicate in a manner that transcends all others. Because, you know, literature, we have few words, but these words will be changed as of the cinematic thought is called, is there no one else? This dialogue has not been mentioned in Troilus and Cressidus. Troilus and Cressidus, there is no dialogue. Well, you coming into the performing way of arts, we have to change according to the audience. This is called the performing arts in literature. In literature, creating of a performing arts, we should make it into a cinematic. We'll make the attraction of the minds. That is what we call the performing of arts in literature. And this is the last one. Visual art in literature is called surrealism. Art is characterized by dreamlike visuals, the use of symbolism and collage images. What we call a surrealism. Have you seen the face of a person here? This face is not very clear. And you can see this elephant. Is it an elephant or is it something different? Is it elephant or is it something different? Is it look so? That is my question. Is it looking like an elephant or something different?
Something different, sir.
Something different. Okay. But it looks, it also looks like an elephant. Okay. One side la elephant mari irukku. Ana elephant nu solla mudiyadhu. Excuse me. That is what he said. Abstract and figurative. As of we thinking about a figurative, we can consider this one as an elephant. As in an abstract aspect of things, we want to take it into a sense. We can say this is a mechanical making of innovation. This is called an abstract and figurative. When we want to figurative something, we can say it's an elephant. That's an imagination. That is what we called emphasizing the expression of the imagination realized in dream. In a dream, we can see whatever we like. What does dream mean? The feeling of inner thought before we are going to sleep, we have a feeling of inner thought. That is called a dream. In a dream, we can see different type of aspects. We can see different type of aspects. And those aspects is being called as a surrealism. Nothing be the real. we can say this is real. That may be real. That is called surrealism. This is what we call a visual art in literature. And not a literal depictions of the known world, but disconcerting realistic for the representation of the subconscious mind. Always these type of visual arts is all used to be called as a realistic thought of subconscious mind. Whatever the things will be used to come in the subconscious mind, it will be taken into a account of direct sense is called surrealism. Okay, now the thing is over. And I would like to say thanks to all. And I just give you a chance to make me any questions. If you have any questions on any part, you can please ask me. Any doubts? Let it be, let us not, this should not be in subject. Subject illama general avum kekalam thappe kedai. Most welcome. Any doubt? Any questions? Hello? Ma'am, யாருக்காவது ஏதும் question இருந்தாலும் கேட்க சொல்லுங்க.
If you have any questions regarding art and literature, you can kindly ask.
No questions.
Okay, sir.
Literature base பண்ணி வேற general questions இருந்தாலும் கேட்கலாம். It's not a wrong thing. Okay. Nothing, right?
Okay, sir.
Okay, thanks for everyone. Thank you for your kind cooperation. I think that I have given you a little bit of knowledge on art and literature. I don't know how far it will be making you comfortable in learning all these things, right? And if it makes you boast, I'm very sorry on this regard, right? Sometimes it may not be attractive to you. So, and thank you for your cooperations, and I really love you all, my students, as of my daughters, as you, I consider you all as my daughters, and I love you all, and thank you for your kind cooperation. Thank you one and all, and I would like to put up my thanks for the Holy Cross management for giving me this particular opportunity to talk with you all. Thank you ma'am.
Thank you so much, sir, and finish it off with the closing remarks, sir.
Sure, ma'am.
Okay, warm greetings everyone. I feel much elated in delivering this closing remarks of this intellectually stimulating gathering. Before expressing my gratitude, let me quote from T.S. Eliot, quote, "What we call the beginning is often the end. The end is where we start from," unquote. Let this end be a new beginning, as we have come close to this end of the program. I now take this opportunity to thank everyone on behalf of the Oracle Literary Club of Holy Cross Home Science College. First, I bow my heartfelt gratitude to our speaker, Dr. Noble James, for having enlightened us with the significance of art and literature. We have learned much from you, sir. Thank you so much, sir, for spending your gracious time with us. I extend my profound thanks to our principal, Reverend Dr. Sister Mary Hilda, who has always been a pillar support in all our department endeavors. I thank you so much, sister. I thank our head of the department, Dr. I. Angeline Priya, for having arranged this wonderful session for our outgoing students. Thank you, ma'am. Finally, I thank the program organizer, Ms. Jose Raj Edel. Thank you, Edel. And finally, thank our students who are much patient even as their time has been extended. Thank you so much. Thank you, one and all. Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you very much. Thank you.